Hey everybody, it's AJ for Disney Food Blog, and I'm coming to you live from Walt Disney World. I am literally sitting in my hotel room recording this right now. I just got back from Toy Story Land in Hollywood Studios. Brand new land opens on Saturday, June 30th. I got a sneak peek with the media preview, and there's so much to tell you, so let's get started. First thing to know is that this is a huge land. I was actually really surprised how large it is. There's only 3 rides and 1 tiny, tiny counter service location, but there's really a lot going on here. It is epic as far as detail is concerned. There are a few things I definitely want to show you detail-wise so you get a feel for what you're actually going to have to keep your eyes open for while you wander around. If anybody's gone through the Toy Story Midway Mania line or queue line, you know how detailed they can get about these types of things with Toy Story. And in Toy Story Land, you're literally supposed to be, well, not literally, but you're supposed to be in Andy's backyard. That's the backstory. And you are the size of a toy. You are tiny. And so that's why they've chosen the landscaping they've chosen and the different decor elements that they've chosen. But you'll see in the concrete, embedded in the concrete, you'll see these giant footprints. Those are Andy's footprints. And it's really, really fun. That's something you wouldn't normally notice. But every once in a while, you'll look down and think, hey, what's that? And then you'll realize that's Andy's footprint. You'll look and see that the rides are being held up by pencils, giant pencils and bendy straws. And so basically the toys or Andy, creating his play area in the backyard, has used these household items to create this giant world in and of itself. It's really, really cool. There's a lot of detail, so keep your eyes open throughout the whole land. So let's talk about those 3 rides first. First, of course, is Toy Story Mania, which we've been able to ride in Hollywood Studios before, but now there's a new entrance over from Toy Story Land. Same ride as it was before, 3D kind of game that you play with whoever you're riding with. Definitely good for kids, so be sure to get on that one. It's kind of a headliner there at Hollywood Studios. The next ride is Alien Swirling Saucers. This one is a kid ride for sure. If you've been to Disneyland, Disney California Adventure, this is a lot like Mater's tractor ride. So you're kind of swirling around and following your little alien in your flying saucer. It's really cute and really fun. And the next ride, of course, is Slinky Dog Dash. And this is the one that everybody's really been anticipating. This is for sure a family roller coaster, but it's not as much of a kiddie ride as maybe Goofy's Barnstormer or something like that. It's for older kids, and there's definitely a height requirement for it. But it's a long coaster. There's a lot going on, a whole lot of detail, and a lot of fun. There's no loops or anything like that. But I would put it on the same level as like a Mine Train in Magic Kingdom. It's maybe a little bit less intense than Mine Train, but it's in the same general area as that in terms of its thrill quantity. But anyway, it's a lot of fun. There's a whole lot of detail to see and explore, especially in the queue line. The queue line is amazing. There's so much fun going on in there. I really, really enjoyed it. Just a heads up, if you ride in the front row, you're going to have a giant Slinky Dog head in your way. So you're not going to be able to see anything or any of the fun elements of the ride. So I would suggest riding in the middle or the back of the ride to really kind of catch everything and see everything on Slinky Dog Dash. All right, let's talk about characters. So characters here, the featured characters are going to be Buzz, Woody, and Jessie, of course. And as of right now, there will be dedicated locations to meet them. So Buzz is going to be when you first walk into the land. He's going to be over there kind of behind the big Woody statue. Woody will be found over near Toy Story Midway Mania. And Jessie's going to be found sort of over by Alien Swirling Saucers. So I'm not sure if that will change up because it would make more sense to have Buzz over by the aliens and Jessie behind Woody, so we'll see, but there will be sort of dedicated places to meet those characters when you're there. Okay, let's head over to merchandise. There's lots of fun Toy Story merchandise, of course. Some really cool things for your kids as well. We spotted a lot of fun new toys and added toys that we haven't seen before, so those were cool. There's some really cute backpacks that say I played at Toy Story Land. Those were really fun. And they've got some t-shirts, of course. So if you get there this summer, you'll get that 2018 opening summer Toy Story Land merchandise, which is cool to have. And then finally, last but not least, let's talk about Woody's Lunchbox. So Woody's Lunchbox is a counter service location. There's no indoor seating though. It's all gonna be outdoor seating. So be prepared for that. It's just kind of a little window as of right now, but they do have some interesting stuff on the menu. They've got a barbecue brisket melt, which is truly delicious. I got a chance to try that with one of the chefs today, and it was awesome. There's a grilled three cheese sandwich, Monte Cristo with raspberry jam. And a Monte Cristo is basically, it's supposed to be sort of a fried ham and cheese sandwich, essentially, and they do usually put on that raspberry jam or some sort of a berry compote on it. One of their headliners is the tachos, which is potato barrels, which are of course tots, and I don't really understand why they don't call them tots, but they don't, tater tots. Corn chips, chili, and queso, and they have this incredible queso that they've developed that's cheddar cheese and cream cheese and some spices. It's really delicious and very, very rich. So if you can get a little extra of that queso on the side, I would definitely make that happen. Another headliner here is what they call the lunchbox tart. This is going to be a snack credit for the Disney dining plan, and it comes in raspberry and chocolate hazelnut with candied bacon. And these are basically Pop-Tarts. This is Disney's version of a Pop-Tart. They're a little bit higher end, but they are very delicious. I got a chance to make two of these today with the chef, and it was really, really fun. But I would actually say I like the raspberry one a little bit better, but the chocolate hazelnut one with candied bacon was really, really good as well. So those will be, I think, a destination snack for sure in Hollywood Studios. They're going to have ice cream floats as well, and they're of course going to have a couple of beers and then grown-ups lemonade, which is going to be vodka, lemonade, and black cherry puree. So I think that'll be really good. That's going to be opening up this weekend when the full land opens. And a couple of interesting things about Woody's lunchbox. The restaurant itself is supposed to be Andy's actual lunchbox. Again, I don't understand why they don't call it Andy's lunchbox, but they don't. They call it Woody's lunchbox. But it's Andy's lunchbox that is sitting open on the ground in his backyard is basically what the concept is. So if you actually look at it, you can see the embossed picture on his lunchbox. If you look at the lid that has been opened to kind of create the overhang for the restaurant. So again, crazy, crazy, crazy detail going on here. Baby Bell is a sponsor of pretty much all of Toy Story Land from what I can tell. And so there's a lot of Baby Bells incorporated into Woody's lunchbox, including Baby Bells that are actually, and Baby Bell, for those that don't know, it's a cheese. It's a cheese that's like wrapped in red wax. And so they've created seats that are little Baby Bells that are, you know, you sit in. It's not real cheese, it's just plastic, don't worry, but it's that you sit in, and then they've used Baby Bell wrappers to kind of make the umbrellas on the tables. So they've really incorporated a lot of cool details, and of course you're supposed to be the size of a toy, so these Baby Bell wrappers are just giant. Another thing I really loved about Woody's lunchbox, on one of the tables you'll see the note that Andy's mom wrote to him in his lunchbox. You know how moms will sometimes write you a little note for your lunchbox when you go to school? Well, you'll see the note that Andy's mom wrote, and it says, "You're my favorite deputy, love mom," which is super cute and made me want to cry. I almost started to cry. I know I'm a dork, but I did. I almost started to cry. Super cute. So that was really fun. Again, just another nod to the kind of detail that they put into this land. It's just amazing. So even if you don't want to ride the rides, you don't want to eat at Woody's Lunchbox, just go into Toy Story Land and check out the incredible detail that the Imagineers have incorporated into it. It's truly amazing. Okay, so before we go, I have a couple of little pieces of information and tips for you for when you go to Toy Story Land. First up, the Green Army Men, which in Disney World had always had no faces, as you know, and we saw last week in Pixar Pier in Disneyland that they suddenly had faces and they were able to talk as well. So those Green Army Men are here at Toy Story Land as well. But FYI, they're now called the Green Army Patrol because women are allowed to be Green Army Men now, which is really fun. Second, this is kind of a tip, actually. I wanted to let you know that right now, Toy Story Land doesn't have a lot of shade. Again, you're supposed to be in Andy's backyard and you're supposed to be the size of a toy. So all of the vegetation is kind of what grass would be at that size. And so there's no tall trees and there's not a lot of shade. So there's a whole bunch of full-on sunshine in Toy Story Land. So be prepared for that when you go. Make sure you've got sunscreen. Make sure you've got built-in plans to go in someplace and get some air conditioning and a little bit of rest as well, because there aren't a whole lot of indoor locations in Toy Story Land. Woody's lunchbox is all outside. And although the Toy Story Broadway Mania queue is inside. The queues for Swirling Saucers and Slinky Dog Dash are all pretty much outside as well. And here's a little tip about Woody's Lunchbox. You definitely want to know that that is going to be on mobile order. So if you have your My Disney Experience app, you can order your food ahead of time and it will be ready for you when you arrive. So definitely use mobile order to bypass all the lines. That's going to be a big deal this weekend when Toy Story Land first opens, and probably for the first few months that Toy Story Land is open, you're going to want to avoid those lines. Also, speaking of lines, the Swirling Saucers and Slinky Dog Dash and Toy Story Mania are all on the Fast Pass system, so you're going to want to grab your Fast Passes for those so you're not waiting in those long queue lines as well. So that's what's happening over at Toy Story Land right now. We're going to be covering it with tons of footage, lots of pictures, lots of stories, and information about Toy Story Land. You can head over to this blog post right here, and we're going to be live blogging all weekend about Toy Story Land. So stay tuned and definitely check it out. So thanks for listening and thanks for watching. This is AJ for Disney Food Blog, and we'll see you real soon.